Hello, my name is Paul Garrett from Orbis Software. In a previous video, I showed you how we could connect into the Microsoft Dynamics NAV web services. Now I'm going to show you how we run those web services from Task Center and how these can be used to automate all sorts of activities, integrations, process automation, workflow, this sort of thing. So what I'll do is I'll just open up my Navision folder where I've got my tasks, and I've got a task here. In this example, I'm going to show you an integration task that's taking customers from another system, perhaps an e-commerce system or something like this, and feeding them into NAV. And in this case, the other system that's generating this is outputting an XML file and just outputting it to disk. It could be that we were reading web services from that system, or we could be reading the database of that system directly. But in this case, it's generating a file on disk for this example. I'll just show you the file. I've got an XML file here. And as you can see, there are two customers in this file. It's a file of new customers. They're quite simple data, just to show you an example. One of them is Orbis Software in the UK, and one is Acme Industries in Miami. If I go back to Task Center and open up this task, I've previously partially built this task, and I'll just explain to you what I've done. I've just done this to save time, and I'm going to focus on the integration step that we're going to carry out in just a moment. I'm going to build into this task. At the beginning of the task, I've got a schedule step that runs the task. That could be another event step in Task Center, such as workflow or a database change or an email event or other types of event. It's then reading that XML document I just showed you from disk and just making the data in that XML available to Task Center. I'm then going to follow that with a web service step, which I'll add in just a moment, which is going to call onto the NAV web services. Then the output from that web service call, which will be my numbers of the customers I've created, I'll save that as an XML file to disk. I could do other things with it here, and take it into other kinds of steps, update other data, but I'll just keep it simple. Then I'm going to rename that file to date and timestamp it, and I'm also going to date and timestamp the original file that I imported, the XML file at the beginning, to mark those ones as these are the processed documents. So, now I'll just add that step, new execute web service connector step, and I'm going to use the output XML from my read XML document from disk step as my input to this process. The web service I'm going to call onto is called, I've called it NAV customer card. And the operation I want to perform against that is a create operation. So now we'll look at the mapping, how I'm going to map into that. And I'll just open this up, make it easier to see. And here I want to map the data from my XML file, my input file, into the NAV record. And this is all the data that it can map into. I've obviously not got all of the data available in this example, but I could map them all. So the first thing I'm going to do is, for every customer that occurs on this side, I want to call on to the create web service, because this create web service creates one record. So I'll just drag from one side to the other, and that creates a simple loop between the two. And I'll drag the customer number onto the number, the name onto the name, the address onto the address, and address 2 onto address 2, postcode onto postcode, city onto city, and lastly the country and the country region code. These two pieces of data don't match between these systems, so I'm going to create a lookup between the two systems. And I'll do that with my functions over on the right-hand side here. I click functions, and I'll just pin that so that I've got them available. I've got a series of different functions that I can apply to the data between the two sides. And in this case, I'll use an internal lookup table. And I'll just map country into that, and I'll do the same on that side. I'll map that country into there and open that up. Look in my table, and this is just a simple table of country codes in one system against country codes in the other. So on the left hand system, USA is my country code, but in my installation of NAV it's US, and for the UK is mapped to GB in NAV. So I could add as many entries as I like here into this table, and Task Center will automatically transfer that data from one to the other. I'll say OK to that, and that's saved. That's the mappings created for this. I could add more complex ones in here if I wanted to, but that's sufficient for this example. Say OK to that. Join up those steps that I've just created and say OK, and that's that task created. Now ordinarily this would run on a schedule, but I'm going to run the task now in a test mode, so I'll queue it now. I'll click queue now, and down the bottom here you can see the task steps initializing and running, and they've all completed successfully. They've all turned green. So now if I go into vision here, I've got my customer list in the vision, and if I just refresh that data, then two new entries appear: Acme Industries and Orbis Software Limited. And if I just open up Acme, you can see that my Miami, Florida customer, and the other one was Orbis Software in the UK. And now if I just go back to that directory where my XML files were originally, you now see that there are two files in this folder. That you can see that the original file, New Customers, has now been suffixed with a date timestamp, and there's a new file in the folder called Customers Added. This file is an XML file which has been created by Navision, by NAV. The web service call has returned this data, and if I open that up, you'll see inside here, here are the two customers that have been created, Orbis Software and Acme Industries, with all their data that's been created, including the keys to the two records, that if I wanted to perform further updates, I'd need those keys. I hope you've enjoyed this little demonstration of how Task Center can be used together with Microsoft Dynamics NAV, and how readily it can update NAV through the web services to create integrations and automations and workflows. Thanks very much.